What's up, guys? Neptune here, and today we have a very special topic for ya. We're back to Dark Souls 3, and we're diving straight into the heart of hardcore, competitive high skill ceiling PvP with this new build. Now, me, my friend, RandomRetard69, tested this build extensively during the course of two best of threes. We came to conclusion that this is literally unbeatable and probably is a new meta. Right after we finished those tests, I started discussing why it's so good and what makes it so OP, and eventually we came to a conclusion that there is something very special about it. To start it off, you get the power only if you name your character Gigolo of Kurim. After studying the art concepts for Dark Souls 3, I've realized that there is nothing out there about this particular character, which is very strange. This must be a special case, I thought. Special cases require special investigations. So I venture to the dark side. I've signed up for the secret forum, where people discuss Miyazaki lore, and here's what I've discovered. Gigolo of Kurim was the son of Laurmantis III, the great warrior of Lordran, one of the original brave knights of Eshuhorn Meror. During the battle with the Abyss, Laurmantis sacrificed himself to stop the spread of the Abyss. However, the day before that, he was battling the Anus, Lord of the Abyss himself. And in this battle, he got his hand served by the laser saber. Yeah, I know you're probably doubting all of this shit, but listen, the time is convoluted, so I'm definitely right here. Anyway. His wife, Mrs. Kvai, used his arm to extract his DNA, thus giving the birth to a child. This child was named Gigolo, in honor of another great warrior of Ulasil, Salvador of Kurim. Now this is important, Gigolo was raised by three great knights of Kurim. First knight is Cancerus Victorious, the one that taught Gigolo to use Estoc. That's why Gigolo mains Estoc. In the Battle of Bulsara, Cancerus stabbed Sean Penn in the liver. So as the rumor goes, since that moment Estoc, if held in the hands of Cancerus, deals 500,000 more damage on critical hits. The second knight is named Lord Avelinus, the master of crossbows. He taught Haokai Go how to shoot dragons, so shooting regular crossbow is pretty easy for this dude. Because of Lord Avelinus, Gigolo uses Avelin. Lord Avelinus always knew that you can't trust anyone in this world, even yourself. So he was always a master of awareness. One day a bandit tried to sneak on him, but Lord Avelinus performed a lightning fast 180 turn and shot the poor fella. This given a birth to a secret no-scope technique that has been passed to Gigolo over the years. The third knight is Retardo Negro, the master of Black Knight Shield Turtling. If Retardo Negro would have played Neo, his guardian spirit would be Turtle. Anyway, as a tribute to his third master, Gigolo is using Black Knight Shield. Rumor has it, Retardo Negro would never release an all 2, not even in his sleep. His secret tech allowed him to keep guard 24/7, and obviously this secret tech was passed to Gigolo of Kurim. So this should explain why Gigolo was so powerful. However, if you want to use this best PvP meta build, you have to follow the steps of Gigolo. Name your character Gigolo of Kurim, get Estoc, get Avelin, get Black Knight Shield. The next part is deciding what stats you want. There is nothing in the lore about that, so let's just settle for 77 dexterity, because making Gigolo being a dex faggot doesn't sound too unusual. Over the course of his long life, Gigolo has mastered several unique techniques, such as running away when others attack you. This technique synergized really well with his inner turtle spirit. But one technique that made Gigolo truly special is the Goku tech. One day he was watching anime on Netflix and saw Goku. That's when he realized that he needs to find a way to teleport. Thus he discovered a wireless connection. Sadly, over the years, Gigolo got old, so he decided to retire. Last time I checked, Gigolo was breeding lambs and helping the orphanage. But his legend still lives on, and if you want to dominate on PvP, you have to follow his steps. So guys, there you have it. The ultimate PvP build exposed. With this video being out, I hope every scrub will be able to harness the power of Gigolo and become true Dark Souls PvP meta player. Oh, one more thing, my friend, I forgot to mention. To make this build work, you have to embrace the true spirit of Igolo.
And wear a pet.